On the line right now is Kim Strong from Lainey's Army. I should say allegedly a lot of roosters, to be fair. Lainey's Army is an organization that defends animals. And Kim Strong's on the line now. What do you think of this whole story, Kim?
Well, it's been going on quite a while.
And did you know it's been going on for a while?
Yes.
And really? and are you the reason there was a raid?
No. Okay. No, the state police are the reason there was a raid.
Well,
the state police
okay.
are the ones that took a complaint from neighbors and people seriously, and they're the ones that did their due diligence and actually looked into the complaints and didn't poo-poo them because it's only, you know, roosters. So, no, the state police are the reason that, and the people that turned it in.
Yeah.
And, I mean, it's local people who saw something and said something and had enough information to give the police to get a start of an investigation.
So,
and do you realize how many times this kind of thing happens across the country? And
well,
the police just go, you know, And we are so fortunate that our police don't do that.
Yeah. So how long would you say this has been going on?
I was first contacted about it in December.
Okay.
So it's been going on. I mean, I don't know how long it was going on before that. I don't think too long, because once they started seeing trucks and people and things that shouldn't be happening, and they started calling people, then they, and of course, here's the thing. The people who are turning it in, of course, we all want instant results. We want it done yesterday.
Right.
You know, but that doesn't happen. And because none of the people who turned it in went to social media and nobody made it a big stink, the police were able to do their jobs.
Right.
You know, and it takes time to build an investigation of this magnitude.
Now,
that doesn't happen in 2 days.
Now, I will say there were people from all over at this.
As far as West Virginia.
That were arrested here. Is this something that is so big, but there aren't many of them? It's so large that people must travel from all over the country to go to these things.
Well, they are all over the country. They just busted some in April in different states. I think it was in Alabama.
Okay.
The Humane Society of the United States has a whole thing on cockfighting. It's cruel. The problem is now you have roosters and a lot of them and getting people to take them. And I'm not sure what the Humane Society is going to be doing with them or rehoming them. But that's a concern now.
Yeah. Wouldn't you say the best thing to do is just butcher them? Because what are you going to do with 200 roosters? I mean, how's the Humane Society going to handle this?
Well, that's a question you need to ask them. But if they need support, this is where the community needs to step up and help them, you know, whether it's the food, the medical care, whatever these birds are going to need, so they're not just absolutely euthanized.
And by the way,
farmers.
They might not be very good at... like if you bring one of these on your farm, they're going to be mean. These are trained. We talk about this usually with dogs, but these are going to be trained to fight. So you bring them in and they peck away at your current stock.
Honestly, I am not that well versed in birds or roosters. I don't know a lot about them. I learned to train dogs by training chickens.
Got it. Okay.
But you know. They need to be reached out to, and if they need help, then we need to give it to them as a community.
Yeah.
But yeah, this stuff goes on, and people either say something and it gets poo-pooed by the police. So the real heroes here are the New York State Police.
Will you?
Because they didn't poo-poo it.
Will you take a rooster?
Will I take your rooster?
No,
a rooster.
No, I will not
take a
rooster.
Worded it the way I worded it. I'm wondering, would you adopt a rooster is my question.
No.
Okay.
Could you picture Kim on Riskany Boulevard?
Utica, so can you imagine my neighbors?
And listen, I got to tell you, roosters are rough because they do the cock-a-doodle-doo thing in the morning.
You know what? I ought to take a couple of these.
You
ought to.
It would wake you up.
They would help your neighbors. They would just adore you.
Yeah. So, but, you know, there are places that it has become pretty much something that's en vogue, if you will, to go out and put chickens in your backyard and they have the little the little hen houses and little chicken coops that you can buy for more of an urban setting. You never know.
Yeah, I'm not thinking in the city of Utica people are going to want chickens.
Yeah, okay, all right.
I'm just thinking that's just not a good thing.
Yeah.
But what, you know, the big thing about this is if you see something, you need to say something.
Yeah,
You need to turn it in. And because this is felony, this is U.S., this is New York State Police handled it, and they did a great job.
Kim, two quick questions. One, was this a known thing in Frankfort? Was this like a known
thing?
No. Okay.
It was known to people who saw trucks coming in and out and people.
And what were the trucks? The trucks
general,
were transporting.
It wasn't like a, not to my knowledge anyway.
The trucks were transporting the birds or it was transporting
yes.
people to watch? Okay. And then one more thing. Herkimer County Humane Society's got all these birds now. I know you're
what
not
would you meet
versed
it,
in this.
You'd meet at a certain location and then a truck would bring everybody in?
I don't know how the actual cockfighting works, but I know that that's what alerted people.
Yeah.
Was the trucks moving birds and people being where they shouldn't be and things being different.
Okay.
I know you said you're
and
not.
And there's a lot of untaxable income involved in these birds.
Sure.
When you think about the wagering that's going on and the hundreds of thousands of dollars.
This should
that's
so
losing.
Far down on the priority list, though.
Is it, though?
Well, yeah,
did
but
somebody
it's
put
not
20 bucks
low
on a bird?
Priority list. Not when you multiply it times all the illegal activities of animals.
Yeah.
Think about it. If people are selling litters, just we'll say litters of puppies.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
You know, they sell puppies for $1,000 a piece. That's $6,000, $7,000, $8,000, $9,000, $10,000 per litter of puppies. You take a backyard breeder that's got 30, 40 of those. You know, you're talking
$30,000, $40,000.
We're talking dogs again, though. That example's dogs.
Well, I think there's, listen, if you're bringing in 40, 50 people that, and who knows more, they're staying at our hotels. They're visiting our restaurants.
I don't think these people are staying at your hotels. I think they're coming in for a cockfight and driving home.
Okay. I don't know. West Virginia's West Virginia's a long trip.
You know, I laughed at what Kim said, but you know, to your point, would you come from West Virginia to bet 20 bucks on a rooster? No, you're probably betting
a lot.
You got to be betting
more than 20 bucks if you're traveling from West Virginia.
And you got to remember, guys, it's a blood sport. These roosters, I mean, you know what? Most of us eat meat, blah blah blah, the whole nine yards. But this is beyond cruel.
Yeah.
This is horrifically cruel to them, and they don't obviously get treated for their injuries. And it's cruel, and there's no reason for it except for some people to get rich.
Yeah. And you do believe they get rich over this? There's that much money that is exchanged.
Nobody would go to the lengths that these people go to if they weren't making gobs of money hands down.
Well, I love the place.
And they're not betting a couple hundred bucks here, guys.
The Bluestone is beautiful. The Flagstone is beautiful there. It's a place that it's a beautiful place. Was the owner? I didn't see if the owner was arrested and charged.
I don't believe he was, but
no.
I don't think so.
Was
so,
this all going on? He didn't know.
And
it?
He didn't know about it. Maybe that's possible. I mean, well, I hate this. Don't. It's possible he didn't know about it. The owner didn't know about it, right? If he wasn't arrested, he didn't do anything wrong.
Anything is possible, and I don't have enough information on that to say anything.
I feel bad if that's the case because his name's all.
Well,
over
I mean.
This.
200 chickens in, or he had 185 in a barn on his property that was a training facility. And
I'm
going to
say, we spent hours there picking through the flagstone. I never heard one chicken. Not one. I didn't hear a thing. So
I have no idea, but I mean, I would assume it's possible, too, that maybe someone who works for him or something said, hey, I raise chickens. Do you mind if I raise them in the back here? And I don't know. I'm throwing that out there. Listen, on the Herkimer County Humane Society, I don't know if they've ever had to do this. What if you wanted to support them or something? What do they need? What do you bring?
Honestly, I would make a call out to them and talk to Joanne and find out what they need to take care of these birds because it's not cheap. You know what I mean? It's they got to deal with the foster homes and whatever they're
Kim,
doing with the birds.
Homes.
They got to deal with it.
Kim,
so,
they're going to have to butcher these. I hate to say
well,
it.
Well.
They're going to have to butcher the chickens.
They
got to
do what they got to do, but there's still costs involved.
Yeah, I agree.
And
okay.
They need to be supported because Herkimer is a small, I mean, you know, it's a small community.
Mm-hmm.
So we all need to kind of step up and help them do what they need to do.
All right. Okay, Kim, very interesting. If people wanted to help out, they could contact you?
No, they need to call Herkimer County Humane Society. Right. And Joe, your hands at this.
So much for stepping
tell
up.
Them exactly what they need.
All right. Okay, Kim, thank you so much. We appreciate the update.
Thanks, Bill.
All right. There we go. Kim Strong from Lainey's Army.